Hey everybody, and welcome back to more Labyrinth of Lies. It's a new day, new recording block, and I'm pretty excited about what's up and coming here because I think we're getting close to the end. Now, since I last recorded, I've realized something that I missed over here. I looked at it earlier, but I completely forgot about it, and I think it has to do with the door that we couldn't get past with the letters over there, and that's that clue that Niobe left here. It talks about the first entry being the bookcase, and then it says second entry is the cast in Greek alphabetical order, which I believe is what we need to enter over there. Now, I think I was making a mistake because I wasn't differentiating between the long E and the short E. So, this over here says that Ada or Ida is the long E, it looks like an H as a capital letter, and the short E is the epsilon, which looks like a normal Arabic E. So let's go ahead and try this out. I think because Grigor's name doesn't have an E in it, we were able to do that without any problem, and so it unlocked the first one, and Grigor is the first name in alphabetical order. So the next name, let's see, we have Thanos, Xenia, and Niobe. So Niobe is the next one. Oh, well let me make sure I got that. Niobe? Okay, I don't know what I'm missing here. There's Niobe, Xenia, and Thanos, and Thanos is... Oh, wait a minute, do we have to go by... Oh, we probably have to go by Greek alphabetical order, so Thanos would be the next person. Thanos... No? Okay, I'm lost. Do we have to start over again? Maybe we have to start over again. Okay, so Grigor. Grigor is Gamma, and then Rho, Iota, Gamma, Omicron, and Rho. We got that. And then, let's see, I'm gonna go for, let me just try normal alphabetical order next. Let's see. We'll do Niobe next. No, that didn't do anything, okay. Well, this is really weird. Grigor... Did I do that right? Let's see. Grigor. Okay, and then we got... Let's try Thanos, then. And I do have N correct, right? Yeah. N is N. Thanos. There we go. Okay, so I just had to start over again. And it is indeed in Greek alphabetic order. So that means that Niobe's next and... Wait a minute. Okay, yeah, Niobe and then Xenia. Okay, they're right next to each other. So Niobe is N-I-B-O-B-I. Isn't it? Wait a minute. There's not like two separate... Oh, because Omega is a long O and Omicron's a short O. Is that it? See, everyone keeps pronouncing Thanos' name as Thanos with a long O. And Niobe also has a long O, so... I was able to spell Thanos with the O here, and... Well, there's no Omega, so never mind on that front. But I did get the rest of Niobe, right? There's no other I? Yeah, there's no other I. N-I-O-B-I. That is how you spell her name, right? Let me just make sure. Oh, it's an E at the end. Oh, I thought it was with an I. Huh, okay. Okay, so Niobe is long E, so that would be this. There we go. Okay, and then finally we have Xenia. There we go. Okay, so now we can get back out here, so... I don't get it. What's the point of doing that? Maybe what we have to do is we have to take the elevator down and then go back? Let me go look at what's back here now. Because I talked earlier about the elevator being all automatic and coming up and down for you. No, it's back up. Okay. So I'm assuming if I went through and went through the secret door again, it's going to be back down, right? Like, it magically goes up and down and follows you wherever you go. So, I'm confused. What is the point of even going through that way? Is that supposed to be something useful for later? I'm kinda lost. Like, I don't get how that helps. See, if I go right back through here, I should have the elevator right here. Yeah, see, it's now down here. It's just odd. Well, at least we solved the puzzle of the door, even if we really don't get anything out of it right now. But maybe we can call people. Let's see if our friends have anything to say.
Hey, hey, hey!
Or maybe not.
Later.
Goodbye.
Okay, so Melina, she wasn't answering us before, but maybe she changed her mind?
You've reached the Melina Rocky's personal phone. Please direct all matters related to the museum to the main office line listed on our website.
No, we don't have Melina anymore.
Can't check that off yet.
So what am I supposed to do to check this off? Am I supposed to talk to Grigor? Because I don't think I've talked to him in a while, but I want to say the last time I tried, he wasn't exactly being very responsive. Well, it's worth a shot. I mean, I don't know what else we're supposed to do right now.
Hi.
Bye-bye.
Nope.
Goodbye.
There's nothing else to do. I mean, we did the authentication stuff for Melina, apparently without needing the wrench and the blacklight, so that seems to be done. We broke into Xenia's stuff. Is there more stuff of Xenia's to look like? To look at? Not look like. So, the other thing, I haven't mentioned this yet, but the other thing that makes me think that the entire cast is involved with this whole thing is that only two members of this cast are actual actors. The other two are not, which is just really weird. I mean, Thanos is not, and Niobe is not. That just seems odd that they have two people who are not actors taking to the stage, and they both happen to be taking to the stage for the very first time. Well, I kinda hate to do this, but maybe I need to solve all the puzzles relating to Niobe's art things here. Or, not Niobe, Xenia. I keep getting them mixed up because they're playing mother and daughter and all that. So, let's go ahead and do that. I don't know where this goes, but I'm guessing it's somewhere up here because it seems to curve around this way, and I just happen to get that right. This one seems to curve over here, and then I heard a clicky sound, which is good. And that's a clicky sound, which is awesome. Where does this go? Oh, right there, okay. That makes sense. That goes there. That goes there. Okay, good. This one is so far a little bit easier than the last one. Last puzzle was kind of a little bit insane. Of course, I didn't help things by being silly about some of it either, so I can't really blame the game entirely for that. Let's do this. That fits in that spot. That fits in that spot. That fits there. Okay, good, good, good. Alright, man, we are going to town on this thing. Sweetness. Okay, we can get this whole outer ring done. There we go. This seems to go up here to match the other one. That goes there. Alright, we are doing really well with this. I probably just jinxed the whole puzzle there, but so far at least I can say that we're doing okay. And we need one that goes there. It's probably going to be mostly black, and it will have a little sliver of that design in the upper right. This one. There we go. I don't have anything for that, though. I do have that. But I don't have the upper left yet. Here we go. Okay, perfect. So now we just need to put everything else in place. Okay, so this has some little hook thingies on the ends. Do we have anything else that has little hook thingies on the ends? Not looking like it. Okay, anything that has kind of stuff like this, that's black but it has some tannish stuff, we might be able to put that somewhere. Okay, it may not necessarily be that easy. It feels like it needs to go down here at the bottom. Oh, okay, it goes there. I know, I just did that the entirely cheap way. This looks like it could match something here. There we go. My question is, why in the world would Xenia have this game on her phone where you have to do this? I mean, does she just do this for fun? Or maybe this little game is how she counterfeits stuff? I don't know. I don't see any obvious match for that, so I'm just gonna move on. This looks like it could go with all of this stuff. Okay, I saw a face. There was a face one. I bet there's two people in this, and one of them is facing this way because their hand seems to be coming from here, and there's probably another one here. Right, there we go. Okay, we got it. So where's the face for the left one? That doesn't exactly look like a face, but it almost does. Huh, okay. There we go. Thankfully, it's kind of easy to tell what color goes where when you can see the shades of the color, so that helps. There we go. If there's stuff that has like a circle thing on it, like this line, that would be very helpful right about now. This probably goes there. Yes, good, good, good. And any more of that bubbly looking thing. I know that I said bubbly, it's not really bubbly. There we go. Maybe this is a head. Which probably means it goes here. There we go. Okay, so we need more parts of that person. There we go. Let's get more of these branches in place. There we are. Yeah, this is definitely going a lot better than last time. Well, I think we've gotten to the long-awaited video where I do all of these, because I'm kind of stuck on everything else at the moment. There we are. I mean, I don't really know what else to do without the wrench. I know there's a lot of puzzles we haven't solved yet, but the problem is that I feel like we need more information before we can solve any of them, and there's some that we can't even activate yet. So, that's kind of pointless at this point. Pointless at this point. There. Alright. This... No... Probably over here, right? Have I said just how much I like this music? It has a very classical feel, but yet it... I don't know, it just sounds... modern at the same time. Like, I don't know how to describe it other than that. It's just really cool. It looks like that should go there, but I know it can't. Where could this go? It looks like it's kind of lighter, but... Yeah, there we go. Okay. There. Good, good, good. There we go. This looks like a hand thing. Probably belonging to this person. Or maybe it's part of the outfit. Yeah, there you go. It's... Well, I don't know. It looks like this is kind of a half-man, half-animal thing. I know there's a name for that, and I'm not thinking of whatever it is right now. And this all appears to be part of the dress. That doesn't. That's part of the man's thing. This looks like it could be part of the dress. That is two. And so is this, right? There you go. Alright, man, we are going to town on this thing. Alright, so we got the man completely done except for his hand, which I think is this. There you go. And now we just got four pieces left. We just need to put this, or this, then this, then this, and finally this.
All done.
Okay, so this is Heracles and Athena, artist Doris, date 490 to 470 BCE, and museum is the Staatliche Antikensammlungen. Alright, next picture. Ooh, this one looks like a tough one. Yeah, this looks like a tough one. But let's use our color strategy here. Let's just figure out what colors go where. And I think we'll be okay. I think we can do this. So up here, it seems to get a little darker. We'll have to remember that. This looks like it should go around here, but I'm not seeing a match for it yet. I'm going to try not to put things in there until I know where they go to, because I don't want to end up with a bunch of pieces on the board where I don't know where they go. Because as we saw with the first puzzle, I think that's kind of what did us in. This looks like it should go around here somewhere. There we go. Okay. See, the more stuff we get, the more we can match things. There we go. This is probably on this side of it. Like, it curves around in a circular shape. I bet that's what this is. This looks like it should go with this thing. There we go. So I need one with another kind of diagonal line part of the pattern there. Okay, that goes with that. Good. There we go. Okay, that goes there. So I just need one more that matches up with this first one and second one. So two more diagonal lines should do. Where are my diagonals? Here we go. Three of them, actually. Okay. So are there no more down there? I guess not. Maybe this is like a boat? It looks like maybe it could be a boat. This probably goes up here. Yeah, it goes way over there. This looks like it's lighter and should go... Yeah, there we go. So more like that. Let's find more like that, like this one. There we go. And this one... I don't know. Oh, there we go. Okay, good. What about this? There we are. So more with that kind of curvy line that goes through there. That would be very helpful. There we are. So any more goldish ones? Because gold equals part of the boat, I think. This looks like it should go there. I don't know what goes up here, though. Like, this whole area is empty, so I have no clue. There we are. Okay, so we got this whole section pretty much done. I just need one more piece to fill that out. Maybe this? Nope. Okay, come on, where are you? There's gotta be something that has a little bit of gold in, at least a little bit of gold in the lower right. Oh, there we go, okay. Alright, so now, let's see if I can fill out this part right here. Okay, that goes there. Does this go here? Nope. I don't know where this goes. Huh. Can't say I'm too sure about that. Yeah, I am not seeing it. This looks like it could be part of this whole thing. Probably not in this row, though. I at least just want to anchor some stuff here that will help us reference other things. That's what I need right now. It's part of this puzzle. Huh. Yeah, this is rather interesting. Wait, does this go up top? Yeah, it does. Okay, so anything that has a border on the top probably goes on top. Okay, let's just work with that. I think we can work with that. Let's see, this also has a border. There we go. Any other borders? Here we go. Alright, we are on a roll. I'm so thankful that these are in the right order. Let's get some bottom ones in. This one looks like it could go here, or here, somewhere. There we go. Are there any on the left and right? I don't see any. Okay, we're getting there. We're at least filling out these upper and bottom sections, which is really helping. Okay, we got the top row completely done now. So somewhere here, we need to put a piece that fills that brown thing out, which is probably that. There we are. There we go. Okay. I think we're getting there. It still beats the very first puzzle where we were just struggling the entire time. Still, I'm glad I'm doing these in a separate video. Okay, that goes in the corner. So it doesn't look like there's borders on the left and right. Kind of a bummer, but it would have been too easy if there were. So this doesn't go anywhere here. Not looking. Oh, there you go. It goes there. And this doesn't go here, it seems. Probably goes somewhere here on the second row. Here? Yeah, there you go. That kind of piece is kind of hard to reference, not gonna lie. I'm still curious about whatever this thing is. It feels like this should be at, like, one end of the ship. Oh, okay, it's over here in the very bottom. I thought it would be at the top. Yeah, I'm kind of guessing when it comes to these ones that are kind of abstract. Yeah. Like, this looks like it could go up here, which it does. There we go. That has a little bit of that darker section. This looks like it could go somewhere here in the middle, maybe? Okay, there. That's part of that. And then this one... What is this? I don't even know what this is. Okay, there. Okay, these are people, so let's put all the people in. It's funny, but some of these you wouldn't really be able to guess even when you mouse over that goes there, just because this puzzle is so complex with all the individual tiles and whatnot. There we are. Okay, so now we just finish that. This looks like it needs to fill out this bit. And I need the other half of that guy's face. There we go. Okay, so we're down to the final few pieces now. Which is good. Oops. There we go, and there we go.
Got it.
This is a Greco-Roman ship, artist unknown, 1st century BCE to CE, and this is from the private gallery. Alright, so we got 3 down and only 4 more left. Okay, so let's see what this next one is. This looks like a sepia-toned painting or something. Which could be very difficult. Okay, that looks like a kind of a vignetting. So let's work with the vignetting. I'm gonna try to get the sky bits in here, but it could be kind of a little tricky with the areas that aren't vignetted. It's looking like this is where the landscape begins. Maybe this is... Yeah, there we go. Okay, I figured that was toward the right side. This looks like it should be... Yeah, there we go. Huh. The vignetting seems... Yeah, there we go. It's on top. Okay, good, good, good. There we are. Okay. As long as we get these buildings partially done, maybe we can tell where everything else goes. There we are. Alright, good. Good. Awesome. This looks like it's on the left side. Upper left corner. Sweet. Okay, we are doing really well. There we are. Okay. Now we needed like a really blank one to go here. Perfect. Okay, good. Okay, so we need more stuff here. Let's go ahead and start filling it out even more. More. Come on, there we go. There we are. Perfect. Okay, we're getting there. This may not be as bad as I was thinking. Huh. Where does this go? Okay, there. Okay, we need more columns. Let's find all these columns. Where does this go? Okay, there we are. So this looks like it should be really far away in the distance, and it is. Okay, that's good. Alright, alright, we are getting there. We need another spot for that this second row, though. Okay. Things are going very well in this puzzle. I'm actually pretty happy about this situation. Okay, we got more columns to do. And I need this part of the building. Where is that part of the building? Here we go. If you look for a specific thing, usually you can find it. Alright, looks like this is like a Parthenon type place. There we are. Okay, so now we just need to get the ground, pretty much. How are we going to start on the ground? That's going to be kind of tricky. Does this go anywhere? It doesn't look like it, but it looks like there's those are pillars. I need to get more anchor pieces here, guys. More anchor pieces. Is this at the very bottom? Holy cow. There we go. Okay, so apparently that's at the very bottom. Yeah, at this point it's kind of grunt work because I really don't have any context for this stuff. Like, this looks like it should be on the ground. Yep. Alright, let's look for more architecture-looking things like this. Yeah, there's that base of the building I was looking at. I should probably look at more stuff that connects that board or whatever that thing is. There we go. Maybe it's a piece of wood. Alright, more of the hill. Come on. I need some references, guys. More references. There we are. Which probably means that this is nearby. Maybe. Looks like it could match one of these areas. Told you guys I was gonna jinx it eventually. Still, it's not that bad. I mean, I'm making plenty of progress, I guess. That looks vignetted, so it makes sense that it goes there. That too. Where does this go? It looks like it has part of the building on it, but it looks also vignetted, so... Yeah, there we go. More rocks, which... yeah, there we go. They match up with those. There we go. More building stuff. And what does this go with? Huh. Oh, there we go. This looks like it's part of a base of a building. There we are. So does this. There we go. Okay, let's get most of these done. Okay, we got that row done. So now it's just a matter of finding all these ground pieces. Okay, let's just keep this up. Wow. Okay, there we go. Oop, it's the Sherlock music. And there.
Done.
Parthenon from Southeast. Artist A.D. White. Architectural photographs. Date circa 1865 to 1889 from the Cornell University Library. Alright, this one looks even more abstract. Oh boy. Okay, let's see if we can figure this out. Yeah, this could take a while. This is really not very obvious. This kind of looks like it could match one of these things, but it looks like a skeleton, maybe? Like a corpse? I don't know. It's something. Okay, let's get... No. I don't want anything on there. Oh, man. Okay. Let's try to look for, like, fingers, toes, something like that to match this thing. It feels like this needs to be here somewhere. But I really don't know where. This looks like it could go somewhere here. Yeah, I'm just kind of guessing right now. Can't say that I really know what I'm doing. But these are heads, and maybe if we get heads, we can work our way down. Okay, that goes up there. So let's try putting heads on the top row and seeing if they click. Because I saw another head. Wasn't there another head? Come on, there's an... Oh, wait a minute. This looks promising. Oh, come on. This has got to be a foot thing, right? Nope. Okay. Wait, this looks like it could go with that. There we are. That I really don't have much reference for either. I thought there was another head. Here we go. Here's the other head. Okay, so that goes way up there. Wow, okay. I want to take that out of that spot. So anything that looks like an arm, let's look for arms. Anything that looks like a bone, arm, whatever type thing. That goes there. Okay, good. More arms? Come on, we need more arms. This looks like it should go down here, but it's not working. How about no arms? Okay, apparently this puzzle wants to be really difficult to not give me any more arms. Come on, puzzle. Wait, this looks like it could go... Wait, I thought this went over here before, didn't I? There we go, that goes there. This looks like it kind of matches that same thing. Maybe it's for this person. Okay, it is for that person, okay. Maybe that's a scarf or something. Excuse me. Does this go with anything here? Anything familiar? I think, I have a feeling that we've already tried. Oh, there we go. So that goes with that. Interesting. Okay, that brushy scarf thing goes there. Maybe these are pictures of statues? It makes sense. I feel like we don't have enough information there. But we do for that, so that is good news. This looks like a hand, which means it probably goes up here somewhere, right? Wait, no, that may not be a hand. Everything is kind of just starting to look the same, you know? It's just not... There's nothing that really stands out about this puzzle. Maybe this goes here? Somewhere? There, it goes with that guy. Okay. Or is that a woman? Maybe that's a woman. Huh. I don't see where to put this guy. Not seeing it. Hmm. What about this? See, like, these pieces are kind of different. Oh, that goes there. Okay. Well, that's helpful because I think we've seen other pieces that look like that, haven't we? At least some similar things. There we go. Okay. I need something that matches this brushy thing on the right side. Anything that matches the brushy thing on the right side would be helpful. Okay, that one goes there. But I need one more that goes on the left side. So far, I am not... Oh, here we go. There we are. Okay, so we got the brushy things. This looks light enough to justify being on the top row-ish. Maybe. Maybe not. There we go. This also looks... Yeah, okay, there we go. That goes there. Oh, so this is a horse thing. Okay. It's a horse thing. That makes perfect sense. There we are. I need more horse parts. Like, maybe... There we go. That goes there. Okay, so this entire thing must be part of the horse. Oh, there's where that was. I was wondering. Okay, we got more leggy things. This doesn't appear to go anywhere familiar. This is what I want to pick up, though. I want more legs. More legs. Perfect. And it feels like this should be a, you know, something muscular, like a leg, but I can't see where to put it. Yeah, I'll come back to that one. I'm kind of a bit afraid about what the last few puzzles are going to be like. Hopefully they're going to be easier than this. Oh, there we go. Curious. Okay, I need to complete this thing here. Can we find that thing anywhere? There we go. We got that. Where can I put this thing? Apparently there, okay. That almost looks like it matches, but not quite. It's funny, like, there's some of these areas you don't think would match, and then they do. So that's why I'm kind of trying to be thorough about checking all this. Wait a minute. This probably goes here. There you go. The more we can clear out, the easier this will be. Again, this looks like a hand, almost. Oh, okay, it's part of the horse's foot. And it almost looks like a horse's mouth, but not really, because we've already got the mouth mostly done. Yeah, I'm not seeing where this goes. What about this? There we go. Okay, we're getting into the kind of the really strange stuff now. This looks like color-wise it should go up here. Yeah, there we go. Let's look for more light stuff. That might be a good strategy at this point. It almost looked like it went on the far left over there. But no, not really. I just need more anchors. I need to have more stuff that I can anchor these pieces around. Alright, we'll come to that later. What about this? This looks like it needs to go somewhere here. Or somewhere up here? I don't know. Where does this go? This looks darker than everything else, so yeah, okay, it goes down there. Okay, let's find dark stuff. Maybe the dark stuff we can all put together. There we go. Maybe this goes with these? Somewhere? There we go. I'm still wondering about this bit here. It feels like I should have filled that out by now. Oh, come on, where does this go? It looks like it's part of the guy's shoulder or something. But it's probably another horse bit. Yeah, I'm thinking another horse bit. Where would this go? Okay, there. Okay. There we go, now we got the mouth done. Oh, come on, this is probably, yeah, there we go, it goes down there. There we go, good, good, good. Okay, we're getting there. Getting there. There we are, okay, great. I need the guy's neck. Where's the guy's neck? This is... There we go. Alright, so we got most of the horsey done. Where does this thing go? Like, this doesn't seem to match any of the things that we haven't touched yet. Where in the world does this go? There we go, down there. Alright. So this probably goes nearby. There we go. Somewhere. There we are. Which probably means we have a blank spot for that lower left corner. I feel like this needs to be down here somewhere. There we go. I guess I just missed that. There we go. We got the neck in. Okay, what about this? There we go. Okay, we got more muscles and stuff down here. Wait, is this another horse? That would make sense, because there's like legs down here and there's legs over there. So maybe this is that this guy's horse, and this is this guy's horse, and this scarfy thing was the mane all along. I'm just now seeing it, guys. I know it's probably super obvious when you're not solving the puzzle and you're just enjoying the video and everything. Yeah, see, I thought that was a horse's mouth earlier, and I just couldn't place it. But like when you're actively working on the puzzle, you kind of forget about it sometimes. just because you don't have everything in front of you, and you're not really thinking, you're focusing on the details, and you're not really thinking big picture. So it's very easy to miss stuff. There we are. There we go. Perfect. Perfect part 2. Perfect part 3. Alright, and there we go.
Done.
Horseman from the Parthenon, West Frieze. Artist unknown. Date 438 to 432 BCE, and museum is the British Museum. Okay, two more. Oh no, we got another one of these orangey ones. We've got another orangey one. Oh boy. Alright, let's get to work. Let's do this. Let's do that. I want to get a leg there. That looks like a leg of a person. It looks like this could also correspond to something here, maybe? Maybe not. Okay, it goes there. Okay, so as long as we can connect all these arms and legs and whatnot to each other, we should be just fine. There we go. What is this thing? It's looking like a snake head, almost. Now this thing... I'm kind of going with the logic from the very first puzzle, where the lighter it is, the upper I go. That doesn't make any sense. Yeah, maybe that's not something I'm ready to put down yet. But that's good. And so is that. Okay, so it looks like there are two people and they're facing each other. Or something like that. Is this part of this person? Okay, it is. Alright, this looks like a head. It looks like the head of the person facing left. There we go, okay. What is this thing? Maybe this is over... They're hunched back or something? Nah, I won't put that down yet. I don't know. This is a tricky one. This is quite a tricky one. I don't know what to make of this. We tried working with that earlier, but that was kind of a bust. Yeah, I don't think this is really going to be helpful right now. Okay, this thing... We also don't have any real reference for it either. But maybe it goes with these. It looks like the same style of stuff as these body parts here. But it's not really helping us right now. Okay, what are all these things with the lines on them? If I had some reference for where those go, this would be a whole lot easier. Okay, so the swirly things go there. Yay for swirly things. Nope. Okay, this is a swirly thing. Is this a swirly thing belonging to this person? It is. Okay, great. So maybe, yes, that's a thing belonging to them too. Okay, and so is that. Okay, we're getting more patterns down that we can work with, so that's good news. There we go. Okay. Getting better. Okay, so these line... The more line-looking things seem to go here in the middle. There we go. So those are hands. Those are not snake heads. My bad. There we go. This looks like it could be part of this. Yep. This looks like it could be part of that, which is good. Okay, I think we're finally getting there. Like, we know where these line-looking things go. And right as I say that, I can't put this one down. There we go. Are they, like, playing chess or something? They're doing something on a table. They're moving things around. This looks like it should go up top. Like, the more dull-colored things seem to go up top. But this, I'm not sure. Okay. There we go, that goes up top. That goes there. Cool. Okay, okay, we're getting there. Where in the world does this go? I don't know. Okay, this looks like it goes there. There we are. I keep coming back to that piece even though I'm clearly not ready to put it on. This one... Huh. I'm not sure I have enough information for that. This one looks like it's a bottom piece, and it is. That's good. That one goes there, okay. This has text on it, and okay, there we go. We've seen text up top as well, so that's good. Does this go somewhere here? Maybe toward the bottom? Maybe not. There we go. And this looks like it goes here. Perfect. Okay, I think I'm getting the shading, generally speaking, down right. So now, I'm gonna look for this table stuff that the guys are playing around with here. Okay, I'm not really seeing where this goes. There we go, it goes there. Okay, I need to just throw all these things down. There we are. Huh, where does this go? I am not seeing where this goes. Yeah, let's not mess with that right now. Instead, let's mess with... Oh, okay, it goes there. If at first you don't succeed, come back later and try again. There we are. There we go. Alright, we're almost done. I think we're almost done, at least. Okay, we need one more. Yeah, here we are. Yeah, it looks like they're playing some game or something. Where does this thing go? I've been wondering about this since, like, the beginning of this puzzle. There, okay. Well, I guess it makes sense. It has swirlies all over it. This thing probably goes there. There we go. This one looks like it should... Yeah, there we are. And this looks like part of his shoe. Where does this thing go? Yeah, I'm not sure where this goes. I keep saying that for like every piece, I know. I'm very glad though, I will say this, I'm very glad you don't have to rotate the pieces, because if you had to rotate the pieces, can you just imagine how much of a nightmare this puzzle would be? I mean, it would be crazy. There, okay. Perfect. Also perfect. Also perfect. There. There you go. Okay, so that goes there. Okay. Alright, I think we got it. Perfect. Achilles and Ajax. Artist Ezekias. Date 540 to 530 BCE. And the museums is at the Vatican Museums. Okay, the final piece. Yay, the final piece. And this one looks like a doozy. Wow. Look at this. Okay, so it looks like there's gaps in between these. Are these vases? Some kind of vessels of some sort. They look like they hold. They're like pitchers or vases or general things that carry water. So, it's going to be a challenge trying to match these up. So, I may have to brute force this to an extent. Yeah, I'm not really sure I'm a big fan of this one, especially since they're all the same color and... yeah... not really sure about this one, guys. I'm probably going to be on this one here for a while. I'm just kind of trying random stuff right now, hoping something sticks and I can just... like, literally sticks there, and I'm hoping I can just build from that, but right now it's like... I'm not sure whether these are like different vessels or this the like one vessel from top to bottom on each of these. It's kind of hard to tell. Like, this looks like it should go down here toward the bottom because it's darker and it looks like it's the bottom of a vessel. So it looks like that is indeed the case. Whereas this looks like it's at the top. So I'm going to try to use that as... there we go. Okay, so maybe that's a good strategy to go with for now. Because this, yeah, that looks like it's at the top, which is good. This looks like it's at the bottom. Okay. Maybe this is... where does this go? There's all these things that look like plateau-shaped stuff, like flat-top stuff. Okay, that goes there, apparently. Okay. Does this go kind of like below some of these gap things? I don't know. Interesting. That one does. That's good. Huh. Okay, that one goes there. Okay, so these do appear to be a singular thing, so that's kind of helpful. Alright, I think I'm kind of getting the gist of it, it's just the details I'm going to have to really work on. So, let's line up all these gap things. Let's work on the gaps. Okay, so we got all the gaps for that one. So now we just need to get all the gaps for this one. That being one of them. This looks like another one, and this looks like another one. Okay, good. Not sure about that, so let's leave it alone. Okay, that goes there. Does this go anywhere nearby? That one apparently goes there. Okay. That goes there, okay. Let's start putting the bottom stuff in place now. I think I'm getting the hang of where everything generally is. It's just a matter of this middle stuff, I think. Okay, any dark ones? Any dark ones I can put at the bottom? Here's a dark one. I just need one more dark one to put at the bottom. Here we go. Perfect. Okay, I've got the bottom row completely done. Okay, so these do go on the top, the plateau things. Okay, let's work on the plateau things next. Perfect. There we go. This one goes... not there. Not there? There, okay. Alright, more of this stuff. Let's do more. More. I must have more. Okay. Where do we get all this stuff for up here? I'm gonna try to look for stuff that kind of has lips in it, like that. Any more lippy things? Any more lippy things? Here's a lippy thing. Here's another lippy thing. We need one more lippy thing. One more lippy thing, just for me. Come on. This one. Yes! Okay, great. Okay, so now we need to fill out row 2. Come on, row 2. There we go. Okay, so there's like a band around here that's probably the second row. Or this bottom area. Or, excuse me, the third row or the bottom area. Maybe that doesn't go there. Where in the world does this go? Oh, okay. Goes up there. That goes there. That goes there. Okay, so far we're actually on a guessing roll here. Aw, streak ended. Well, all streaks have to end at some point, right? But we're having some luck here. Things are going fairly well. There we are. Let's get more of these bands in place. These little trenchy groove things. Trenchy groove things. That's a very technical term. Very technical term. Perfect. You know, I better at least get an achievement if I don't actually contribute to the story by doing this. I feel like this needs to be here on the left side, but maybe it's this one. There we go. Okay, let's find ones that have a blank left part. Or a blank right part, like that. Because I think that will help. The way these are cut really helps with that. That one almost looks like it has a squid on it. Maybe that's an early Cthulhu or something. Where does this one go? This one? Come on, you gotta be around here somewhere. There we are. Perfect. We almost have this, guys. We almost have it. No, it doesn't go there. There. Okay, great. And bam.
All done.
Sweet, we got an achievement. Alabaster perfume bottle, seen from the Iliad. Artist unknown. Date 3rd through 1st century BCE. Private gallery as the museum. Alright, so I guess that's just for an achievement, but hey, it was still fun, and we got to solve all the puzzles, so that is the puzzle video. So in the next video, I'm hoping that we'll find out whatever it is we need to do next, so I think I'm gonna just kind of look around until I find it, and then I'll pick up recording then. So until next time, guys, take care, and I will see you on the flip side, and once again, thank you for watching.